Hello everyone, a warm welcome to all of you. Are you guys able to see my screen?
Yes, okay.
A warm welcome to all of you. Hope you all are doing good and are safe in this pandemic. Having you all in the online Magento Meetup Lucknow is really a pleasure for all of us. And in this pandemic, we had faced a lot of issues. People are suffering from this disease. They are dying. Businesses are not doing well. But we also have got some positives after this pandemic. We are having the good e-commerce section, which is doing really very great. As well as, if I'm talking about the meetups and all those things, then previously, whenever the meetups were used to be organized, they used to be organized in a particular city. The experts from that particular city used to speak about the Magento and people used to join from there. But after this situation, the new normal, we are now having the online virtual meetups. And because of that, we used to have the experts from Magento, from the global area, from all over the world, and people will be able to join that particular meetup from anywhere on any place, and we will be able to learn a lot of things from here. I, Madhis Sukla from CedCommerce, I had started as a software developer trainee and working on Magento from 2010, and it was my first framework. I'm also working as an e-commerce strategist and trying to help the merchants to provide to convert their offline store to online store, as well as to help them to build a marketplace solution. You can follow me or join me on LinkedIn. On the below, I had shared the credentials. Today, we are going to discuss about the Magento security by Asheesh Singh. After that, we are going to have the discussion about the Magento Community Project Lifetime, Adobe Stock Integration by Sergi, and then Product Recommendations with Magento by Manish Mittal. I would first like to invite Mr. Asheesh Singh from Bond Group. He's a senior software engineer, and he started work basically in 2012 with CedCost Technologies, and I had loved to work with him. He is a good programmer, keen learner, and have very deep learning in Magento. So Asheesh, I would like to invite you first to start your session. Also, it's a humble request to from all of you, please mute yourself. And if you have any questions, you can just write down on the chat, and we will try to reply all the things after the session will be ended. Thank you. Asheesh.
Yeah, thank you, Madhit. Hello, everyone, once again. And as you all already know, my name is Asheesh, and I started my career from the CedCost, and I started into Magento, Magento 1, then Magento 2. Currently, I am working with Bond Group, and Mudit discussed with me about this opportunity, so I said without thinking any minute, just said yes, because I know this is going to be a good session, and we are going to take lots of things from here, right? Okay, so as you already know the topics, so let me share my screen first. Okay, so for the security, everyone already knows what is the security, everything you do on the e-commerce or anything is involved in the security, but especially for the e-commerce, if we talk about the e-commerce. So I'm going to discuss about those areas which impact the e-commerce, and what is the importance of the security in the e-commerce, and what will be the best practices we can apply while developing or while deploying the things on the production, on the, or maybe the dev environment, or maybe the staging environment. So let's start with this. So the first question everyone's in mind comes once they think about what is the importance of security in the e-commerce industry. So according to a research, if we go for the research, according to a study by the IBM, reveals that average cost of a data breach is $3.86 million. While the average time to identify and contain a breach is 280 days. Like, it takes too much time to identify the errors, the security threats. Malware and the digital skimming are among the most common attacks. So the most common attacks is hackers try to inject some or maybe send some malware to your system, to your e-commerce website, so that later on he can send those information, sensitive information, to the any relay host or maybe their final destination. So these are the malware and the digital skimming are the among the most common attack vector for e-commerce site. So scanning is run by the SenSec, which told us recently this is scanning run by the SenSec, and it told us like credit card skimming malware was detected on 8,170 unique store across all platforms, right? Whatever platform developed in whatever technology, it can be in Magento, it can be any technology, but overall 8,170 unique stores which found malware. And what they observed, like 82% of the store that had malware, we are running an unsupported version of the product. Like, they are not upgrading their product, or they are using the old version of the whatever the framework they are using, the Magento. And 24% of all affected stores suffered multiple malware incidents. So this suggests that one out of the four merchants are unable to identify the root cause. So between four, there is a one which they cannot identify the what is the cause of this malware attack. So, and they are not able to close the unauthorized access through the malware. So on an average, skimming malware was present on compromised store for 13.2 days. Like, this is the average. They eliminate this malware in an average 13.2 days it takes. So it's very important to like aware about the security and know about the threats. So how we can overcome with this? So this is only one way. Security awareness is the first step for your security. Like, if you want to secure your website, if you want to secure your Magento installation, then only one thing can help you. Like, you must have the awareness. So awareness is important. So let's go for, so let's take the targets. Like, what hackers targets? Like, what they can target on the e-commerce website? So they can target about your customer identity theft. They can target about the payment card details so that they can capture something, or maybe suppose you are using the PCI compliance server, or maybe you are using the direct post to the payment gateway something integration. But they can also reroute your customer to a false payment page if you are not written your code as per the security norms. Or maybe they can alter an order before it's transmitted to payment processors. Another sensitive information they can target for your e-commerce store. What will be the consequences? So consequences will be a compromised site can have a long-term consequences for both customer and merchant. Like, customer might suffer financial loss, identity theft, and merchants can face damage to their reputation, loss of merchandise, higher processing fees, the threat of losses, lots of things merchant will also suffer. So let's start with the general recommendation. So in this section, I will give you the general recommendation who any merchant, any Magento installation store owner can apply, a developer can apply in order to protect our e-commerce website. So I will give you the only five recommendations for now. Like, this is the most priority recommendation. You have to have implement these recommendations. Like, as the latest Magento supports two-factor authentication for admin panels. So you can always enable the two-factor login, two-factor authentication for the admin panels. And also for all your SSH connection, enable it so that no one can log in from different device or from the different so it will ask for the OTP or it will ask for the suppose you are using the, so there is a lots of tools available. If I will show you, so to enable the two-factor authentication, there is lots of integration available in Magento, like Google Authenticator. Google Authenticator is a one of the application by the Google. You need to install that application in your mobile, and by this application, you can enable through the admin panel of Magento and connect your app with that panel. So that every time you try to log in through the Magento admin panel, it will ask you to validate through the Google Authenticator first. And there is other applications also based on the different requirement and the different setup. Like suppose you want some integration kind of things. So there is a U2FO keys, Authy, Leo security. So these basically works as a two-step validation authentication. So you must have to enable this for your production website. Set up and use the non-default admin URL. So the common mistake everyone do, like they follow the like the admin URL slash admin or something. But by default, Magento, like Magento, in Magento 2, they introduce, they are generating a unique admin for each installation, right? But again, we can also change it. So it is recommended to use a non-default admin URL, something which hackers cannot predict or something. So you can set up it. And it can be set up through the like env file or maybe through the commands also you can set up. So there is a lots of method you can apply. Like you can set up the backend URL through the env file or maybe through the admin panel there is a settings where you can put your backend URL or maybe through the command if you want. So you can CLI command also, set up config set and the backend front name and give the value. Okay, now, and the third thing, keep your code up to date by installing all patch releases from the Adobe Magento. So as you can see in my first slide, like 82% of stores are not up to date to the whatever the latest version of their framework. So it's most important to update your code whenever the releases comes, you need to update. If you are not able to install the full version of the upgrade, you have lots of customization, then you must install the security patches because Magento is releasing the security patches for each version. So that if you are not comfortable enough to upgrade into the latest version, you can go for the security patch version. So there is always a version hyphen P1. P2, whatever the security patch, and you can simply install it to your store, make it up to date in terms of security. Fourth thing will be like implement lock config and lock env environment variable. So you all aware of the configurations which admin can set through the store configuration area. There admin can set lots of value through the configuration. But what about if your admin login compromised, someone stole your admin login, and you don't want some information no one can change? So you can lock your config for whatever path you want, you can lock those config. So what will happen once you lock the config, it will basically import your configuration from the table into the config.txt. And if you lock through the env, it will copy your configuration from the table to the env.php. So what the difference between lock config and lock env? Basically, lock config will generally use whenever you have multiple installation. So you can use the lock config, and it is the super from the lock env. So whenever you have multiple installation of the Magento, you can always lock the config so that whatever configuration you lock into the config, you can share through the other installation. But suppose there is some thing like the base URL or something you want to lock, so you can always go with the lock env so that for each installation, it can be a different base URL. So you can lock the base URL using the lock-in. So if I will show you how it will work. So this is the tab docs of Magento. Here they mentioned already like how you can lock this. So this is the command like bin Magento config set, and you can provide the whatever the argument and whatever the path. So it will set you. Let me show you some example like this. So here they want to set this value without locking. But if you want to lock this, you can always use this value. So what will happen, whatever the value of this path web URL user store, it will be locked into the config.php. So admin would not be able to change it. Only the CLI command can, CLI user can change it. So it gives you another layer of security over your configuration. Now, if you have doubts, like you have the malware already injected in your website and you are not able to figure it out, so you can always go for the security scan services, which is freely available from the Magento, and you can scan your store or website. So it needs, you have to have an account in Magento, and from there, you can go for the security scan, add a site, and here you need to put your URL, your site name, and this is your unique header. You need to put this header into your website. Why they are doing this? So that no one can scan others' website. Only the owner of the website can scan their website. So you need to put this header into your website. And then once you scan, it will give you whatever the threats available, whatever the section which are not protected enough, so you can protect them. So these are the five steps you every like in first go, like in priority, you can take. Now go to the file permissions. Like once you install the Magento, everyone confuses with the file permission, like how, like which file would be in which permission, which will be in the write permission, which will be in the read permission, which will be in the execute permission. So I will give you the standard permission which Magento recommend. So for permission, let me give you the first, the what, how the CH mode is work generally. So in CH mode, there is a three, after CH mode is the syntax, after there is a three key factor, like first would be the reference, then operator, then the mode, and then the whatever file directory and whatever you are putting there. So reference is something to whom you are referring, like to whom you are trying to give this permission. So it can be U, G, O, and E. What the mean? U means owner, like file owner. Whatever owner, whatever the owner of current owner of this file, it will get this permission, whatever permission you are going to give them. If you are using the G, that means the owner group will be privileged with this permission. If you will give the O, that means it will give the permission to the other user except the current user. And if you give the A, that means it will give all the users. So based on your requirement, you can use. Now go for the operator. So how many operator can be possible? Operator can be possible plus, minus, equal to. Plus means it will add the specific modes to a specific class. Like it will add some more privilege, some more permission to the current user or current group. Minus means it will reduce that permission. Suppose user have the right permission, now you want to remove that, so you can use the minus. And if you want to give them exact permission, like only this permission, whatever old permission you want to omit that, so you can use the equal operator. Now go for the how many modes possible. So modes can be possible R, W, X. R means permission to read the file, W means permission to write or delete the file, X means permission to execute the files. Now, what Magento recommend? So whenever you install Magento in your development environment and you start development or you deploy on the production, first you can use these permissions to start your development. So in this, all the file type will be, we are giving 644, and all the directory type we are giving 755. And then we are giving the these areas, pub static, pub media, generated, app, etc. Whatever the files containing these folder, we are going to give the group write permission. So this is the G plus W means we are giving the owner group to the write permission. We are adding the write permission to the whatever privilege they have already. Here, what we are trying to do, here we are trying to do for the directory, we are trying to give the same permission. And also we are setting the ID so that the new files can share the same permissions. Now we are giving the dot, dot means all the directory where we are giving the permission, we are changing the ownership of the that directory to the particular group, so that our CLI will access through that group only. Now here, bin Magento is our CLI command package. So for min Magento, we have to give them the U plus X, means user plus X means execute. So we need to, we have to give them the user execute permission. Now, so when you are on default or developer mode, like you are developing the Magento and you are customizing the Magento, in that case, these are the directory. You can give them user write permission directly, so that they don't face any challenges while development. Now, once your site is ready and now you are ready to deploy and you already deployed, so you need to remove these write, remove write access from these folders. How you can remove? So first you need to set up the production mode, and then how you can remove? You can remove using this command. Like these are the folders, directory path, and then what they are trying to do, what we are trying to do, we are trying to do file and directories. We are trying to remove the write permission from the user. And for all user, we are trying to give all permissions for the ENV file. So the current user will not able to edit this file, but all other user can edit. So by this, we are removing the write permission from the production website. Okay. The next major thing will be select the right solution integrator in the extension vendor. So whenever you need, we require to install a third party extension or something, you always go for the marketplace, Magento marketplace, or maybe the trusted vendor only. So, and also you have to have set some limit of number of extensions so that you don't have to check like how many extension, the third party extension we have. If possible, then review the extension before installing it so that your security never going to be compromised. So if possible before installing any module, just review it quickly. So let's say if you have already attacked by some malware or something, suppose you have the compromised Thank you.
Hello, Ashish. Hello. Ashish, your voice is breaking, I think, from last one slide. Can you recheck your connection and after that again proceed?
Hello.
Yeah, Ashish.
Yeah, it's fine. I think my system rang something.
Yeah, it's fine now. You can like a little bit. You can slow down the mic volume, and after that,
it's okay.
Good.
Okay. So,
Ashish, we are not able to see your screen.
Yeah, okay. Give me a minute.
I can share your screen. I can share your PPT if you want.
Yeah, just share me.
Are you able to see my screen, Ashish?
Yes, I can.
Okay, so I'm going to that particular
slide.
Yeah. Okay. So you can just send me to next. I will.
Yeah. Sure. Next page. Okay, so what kind of like, okay, sorry for the interruption. I think my laptop have CPU utilization 100%. I don't know why, but okay, I will figure it out. So what kind of attacks, so the at the time of inspection, you can inspect. So what kind of attack it can be possible, like defacing of site, botnetting, direct attack on servers, silent card capture, silent key logging. Silent card capture means they are trying to take some credit card information to make some payment or some fake payment something. Key logging is something like they put some malware in your system, and then once their code executed, they transfer the information to their relay host or maybe their the final destination. Yeah, next page. So try to find the attack vector to determine how the site was compromised and when. So review the server logs file and file changes. So sometime multiple different attack at the same system, right? So you need to check the what file got changed or what the permission of the file got changed or what about the content change in that file, or also look for the logs of the server. If possible, wipe and reinstall everything. So now suppose you are not able to identify which malware installed in your server. So you can simply reinstall everything, like just So in that case, if you are virtual hosting or AWS anything, so you can simply create a new instance and initiate all your services or your packages to that instance and install it. Then apply all the latest. So suppose you haven't applied the latest patches from the Magento, then you need to apply the latest security patches immediately. Reset all your credentials, including the database, file access, payment and shipping integration, web services, and admin logins. Reset all the credentials, like change all the passwords. If payment information was compromised, it might be necessary to inform your payment processor. If suppose something stolen or something compromised related to payment, so you can't recover this, so you need to inform the payment provider, payment processors. Inform your customer about the attack and type of information affected. If payment information was compromised, then they should look for the payment processors. So if you need to inform the customers also. So that was the plan how to recover from attack. Now we are going to discuss the detailed security checklist, which you can immediately check before deploying or you already deployed stores. So for that, first thing will be, which everyone recommend, use HTTPS. Like, it helps your information to travel between the networks call securely. And also the Google recommends, also Google gives you the greater rating in terms of searching. So you must have to use the HTTPS. And also, some aware, like user also aware about this. So suppose your site is taking some payment information or something, so user always look for the HTTPS website. So it's good to have the HTTPS. Now if you are not using the HTTPS, so how malware can attack in a simple Magento website? So what they can do, they can insert some malicious JavaScript code. Malicious code to your head, and then it went, and whatever they have written their code, it much may be encrypted or something. So they can later on, they can send those malware sensitive information to some relay host. Relay host is actually a compromised host, compromised website. So you use the different domains. So you never, suppose you are inspecting your code file and you see some different URL, so you never bother, like maybe it's a different bother and it is maybe the different URL, familiar URL, but that website is also got compromised. So finally they send the information to the from the relay to the final destination where they want. Okay, so now how you can protect against malware? If suppose your site is attacked by malware, then what steps you can take to protect against the malware? So first, there will be some general recommendation. Then there will be the audit admin account. You need to audit the admin account. You need to audit the code. You need to audit the database. Then you have to check into the Google warnings. If Google is saying some warning or malware attack, so after removing all the things, you need to again scan through the Google, like is it malware removed or not. Yeah. So general recommendation would be like engage your system integrator and appropriate security personnel to direct investigate and to the whatever area, whatever effort they need, they just investigate it. And you can archive your current environment and store into secure location. Create a database dump. Backup your entire web root into including media, admin, everything. Just take a backup. Now remove all data schemer code from the absolute header. So how you can do, like from the absolute header, from the admin panel, you can go into the design configuration HTML head. And remove all the codes, all the whatever code you have put it there, whatever code, maybe it's a tracking code or suppose something, the code, you just remove all the codes so that you have no doubt you have the cleaner website. Also from the footer, you need to remove all the miscellaneous script. Then scan the site using publicly available tool. You can also use the Magento scan tool to scan your website after doing these steps. And then you can install the latest version of all the extension. If you are using some older version of extension, third party extension, you can install the newer version of extension into the non-production version. Then later on, you can push it to the production version. Now go for the user credentials. So it's the same, like you go for the permission and remove all the users which is no longer they are using their credential. Change the password for all the remove unused accounts, including the integration API, including the every kind of SSS user, just reset it. And also remove all the design like miscellaneous script, so you can leave the tracking code and everything. Other than that, you can remove all the code, whatever the available in the miscellaneous header and footer. Yeah. Now you need to inspect your database. So for that, you need to inspect the store procedure. If any modification in your store procedure or something in your schema, you need to identify. And then you need to verify the database is only accessible by the Magento Commerce instance. Like, is there any user compromised of the database or not? Verify the malware is no longer present. Like, scan the tool using the tools and change the backend URL from the admin. Like if you have used something, you need to change it. And closely monitor it. Like for the few days, you need to monitor it. Also remove the Google warnings, whatever Google is saying, like the malware found or something. So you can always remove the Google warnings. Now, first, suppose you are not able to identify the malware, so you can go for the search through the Google or through the search engines. Like, is there whatever attack you are facing, is there common pattern or is there any malware which is already they have attacked some website or maybe some other stores? So you can get the steps to how to step, you can easily get the steps to recover. So you can always go for the search, like what kind of things you are facing, you can always search and you can get immediate the answer. And if you are not able to clear it out, you are not able to fully clean this your website, so you can go for some reviewer or maybe some integrator, solution integrator who can help you. Now when dealing with the advanced attack, the best course of action is to work with the experience. So if you want to secure website and clean the website, so you always need to work with the experienced developer or something. And developer, the third party developer and the solution integrator, it must be like reliable. They have the credibility. You need to use those modules only. And you follow all the coding standards and securities. Now protect against password guessing attack. So whatever the access point, like change the URL, whitelist IP you can use, like for the backend to disallow all the IP, only the whitelist IP can access your backend URL. So by this, no one can guess your password, no one can guess your the backend URL. Some of the PHP function which like deprecated in terms of Magento. Magento clearly said about these function, don't use these function because these function gives malware permission to execute their script. So you need to avoid these functions like evolve function, serialize, unserialize, MD5 because they have already compromised and they can break it. srand, MT, srand. So these functions you can avoid while development. So one big terms, if you are a payment, you are taking the credit card information, you are processing the credit card information through your servers, then you must have to be PCI compliance guidelines. You must have to follow the PCI compliance guidelines. So PCI compliance guideline is a guideline which every server need to be follow. Which server going to take the credit card information or process the credit card information? So those server must have to follow the guidelines. So there are 12 guidelines given by the payment card industry, and these are the 12 guidelines. So first is install and maintain a firewall configuration. So you can read it out. So these are the server, these are the 12 rules, 12 guidelines you need to follow if you want to process your credit card information, customer credit card information through your servers. Either in alternative, you can use the direct post method of the Magento, direct post from the browser to payment gateway. So there will be no need of storing or sending the credit card information or the customer information to the servers. You can directly post from client browser to the payment processors. So if you are using that technique, so you don't need to be PCI compliant servers. But if you are processing something, you are taking some payment, EMI concept or something, then your server must be PCI compliant. So that's it from my side. These are the references I used for preparing this amazing document for you guys. And the last slide, okay. Yeah, this slide. So you can see like time it takes for a hackers to crack your password. So you can see if you are using only the four numbers and only the four number, hackers can immediately break your through the brute force. They can immediately break. So similarly, you can see like if you use the letters four character letter, then it will be immediately they can compromise. So you can see the strength of the combination you can use and number of the character you can use. So how your password become a more and more secure. So you need to follow this for your password protection. Whenever you are using the password for each of the kind of the like for your Gmail, for your mobile, because suppose if your system got hacked, so anyhow you are accessing the admin, so maybe something injected through the server or something. So everything, whatever you are using, it must be protected and must be password protected. And password pattern also be follow this rule. So based on that, you have an idea like how you can give a strong password for any system. Yeah, that's it guys. Thank you. If you have any question, you can raise. Thanks Mudit, thanks everyone.
Thanks Asheesh for your insightful session. And if anyone have any questions, you can just write down in the chat box. Asheesh will try to reply them in the chat box as we are running out of time also. So as or if needed, then you can also connect with him on the social media like LinkedIn or Twitter.